And continuing our coverage tonight of the great gasoline debate, we have heard from so many of you about your concerns regarding Central Oklahoma's high gas prices right now. In fact, compared to the nation, 37 other states have less expensive gasoline than we do. That includes both California and New York. Tonight, an Oklahoma lawmaker responds to the standard reasons given for the spike at Oklahoma's pumps. Eyewitness News 5's Kimberly Lohman joins us live tonight. Kimberly.
Tyler, all summer we've heard from car drivers, SUV drivers about the pain at the pump. Yesterday we heard from the gasoline industry, and today we talked to Representative Mike Shelton. Our station is in his district, and basically after he heard the industry interview, he said he's not buying what they're selling.
Issue number one in the great gasoline debate, how high?
We don't know how long it'll last. We don't know how high it'll go.
It concerns me when we use words like we don't know how high the gas is going to go. If we have a terrorist act or we have a hurricane that knocks out oil rigs in the Gulf, we will suffer.
And are we suffering now because a Kansas refinery went offline?
Unfortunately, Coffeyville going down has caused some supply problems.
Coffeyville really didn't have anything to do with the gas prices in western Oklahoma, even southern Oklahoma.
So why the regional differences?
Gasoline is sold on contracts. That is sold at a certain price. This is not sold at a certain price.
I find it curious that Texas can find many of its gas pumps 50 cents cheaper than Oklahoma.
So who is benefiting?
It's not the retailer who's making tons of money. He is at the mercy of his supplier.
I don't know who's price gouging, but somebody's gouging somewhere.
And just about everywhere, there's anger.
When it's high like this, you get mad.
You hear a lot of people choosing between prescription drugs and food. Well, now it's gasoline, trying to get them to church and everything else.
By the way, the Oklahoma Attorney General tells me there's no evidence that there's price gouging or fixing in Oklahoma right now. Shelton has some other ideas. He says all of this pain at the pump points to the need for better public transportation, for more of us to conserve energy, and also for all of us to take action, to call our politicians, everywhere from the Corporation Commission up to Congress. Reporting live in Northeast Oklahoma City, I'm Kimberly Lohman, Eyewitness News 5.
You sure do love driving, though, Kimberly, no matter what the cost. Thank you. Now, another issue Representative Shelton raises with us is whether Oklahoma needs another refinery. We haven't had a new one here in our state in more than 35 years.